Welcome to PJ's Worship, a virtual worship experience brought to you by the First Congregational Church of Dudley, Massachusetts, a United Church of Christ church.
Well, welcome, welcome, and welcome. I am the Reverend John White, the extraordinarily blessed pastor of this First Congregational Church of Dudley, United Church of Christ. Folks, call me Pastor John. I certainly hope that you will too. Welcome if you are gathering with us for the first time, for the thousandth time. Welcome to you. Welcome to worship for this Sunday, the 19th of March, third Sunday in Lent, this week titled Coming Home. For more, see our weekly e-newsletter, PJ's Place. Sent to you a couple of days ago on St. Patrick's Day, the 17th day of March, and PJ's podcast, which will go out as always through the PJ's Place mailing list Wednesday morning. This coming Wednesday morning, the 22nd of March, we will be in spring. Spring happens tomorrow. That it's a happy note, I think. 7 a.m. on Wednesday morning, this week's podcast titled Home, Where Love Lives, and this week really inspired by an experience I had just last Wednesday. So do check in on that. For those who don't know what I'm talking about when I talk about PJ's Place, this weekly e-newsletter, the number one communication tool that goes out to well over 500 mostly local computers, video, prayer, reflection, joys, concerns, events happening, so much more. If you're here in our sanctuary, would like a hard copy, there are some available in that space before you entered our sanctuary today. If you are in our sanctuary, know that in a short while we will be passing plates, taking a financial collection. And today, most or all of you should also have this envelope. This is a wider church offering that happens once a year. One great hour of sharing this giving to the wider United Church of Christ, providing immediate aid and long-term support to people experiencing hunger, thirst, disaster, or crisis around the world. And as you might imagine, the need has never been greater for that. I've been putting out an opportunity for how you might give to that directly online through PJ's Place. But for those who prefer to give more old school with those envelopes, you have those today. Feel free to drop them in our plate here, and our church will send them off to the wider church from here. Continue to check out all the websites, the wider United Church of Christ at UCC.org, the Southern New England Conference at SNEUCC.org, our local church at UCCDUDLEY.org, where you'll learn so much about the vibrant life of this church family. If you're joining us on YouTube, a special welcome to you. You thought I was going to forget you today? Nope. A special welcome to you from wherever you might be joining us today, from home or assisted living community, nursing home, possibly a hospital room today. Welcome to you as always. Thank you for continuing to send in your financial contributions to First Congregational Church of Dudley, 135 Center Road, Dudley, Massachusetts, 01571. And from wherever you join us today, welcome, welcome. Know that no matter who you are, or where you are along this journey of your life, you are so deeply welcome here. Welcome. Welcome now.
Thank you.
Our acolyte who just came forward, Clara, just one of many children in our Sunday school who were offering amazing talent last night at our talent show. And Sarah, our Sunday school administrator, God bless you. Thank you so much. You are doing such a great job, by the way. You really are. And families with young children growing our Sunday school again. And I just thank you for that. For Sarah's dad, or to Sarah's dad, a special thank you. The meatballs were delicioso. And there's some more sale downstairs after worship today. So if you're not sure what to do for dinner today, there you go. Hey, today is the last day to order flowers for Easter morning. And I've heard that the orders are a little bit light this year. And that today's the last day to order. By the way, I myself, last minute, so pardon me just so I don't forget, Patty, here's our order. Do not forget to get in your flower orders. Wow. Hello. That's all right. Michael, good morning to you. We'll see you for a puppet story in just a short while. So many joys and concerns. We had such a meaningful fundraiser out at the TSKK for Dana-Farber yesterday. Sarah and I and Oliver out there with other members of our church family yesterday afternoon before the talent show and church supper for our Sunday school. So just wonderful. One of, hello, Kirsty. Is CJ here too? Well, that's all right. But you'll notice I did put something out on PJ's Place this week, the missing piece to CJ's puzzle, the inspiring story inspired by our own CJ Tarr. Get your copy now. The obituary for Chris Ducharme. And there's a copy right here. There you go. Proud mom. That's awesome. Thank you, Kirsty. Chris Ducharme, the obituary for Chris Ducharme, did go out on PJ's Place. That service will be this coming Saturday at 10 a.m. at St. Anthony's, just down the road. So many other joys, concerns. Had a visit with Dale Romer this past week, who is now home again. So much to hold in our heart and in our prayer. I want to make special note of flowers on our altar here, these gorgeous flowers on our altar given this day by Elaine in honor and in loving memory of all members of her family, the Zakowski family. These flowers down here on this gorgeous table here, flowers given in loving memory of Drew, in loving memory of Drew this day, whose birthday was yesterday, given with such love by Joyce this day, by Joyce Mazzoni. All the memories contained within, and all the life which comes forth, not only from both these bouquets of flowers, but all the life, that all the love of these people shine forth. We give great thanks at this time. Let us be in an attitude of prayer. Dearest God, we focus today on home. Certainly the people represented in these bouquets of flowers, those who come to Elaine's mind through this bouquet on our altar, Drew held forth by this gorgeous bouquet given by his mom, Joyce. All the love represented there centers us on home, dearest God. So much centers us on home this day, the talent of children shining forth through a talent show. So much centers us on home, the challenges of this time, the joys of this time, being together now. Hear us as we pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread. Forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. Lead us away from temptation. Deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, the glory forever. Amen. If you're new to us, you're looking for this new century hymn book at this time. And if you would, let's turn to number 199. Stand if you comfortably can, but let's all sing together At the Cross, number 199. you please be seated, except for children, whom I would invite forward at this time. Layla and Aria. I was determined to remember your names today. Come on up, Layla and Aria. Come on up. Jacob and Michael. Hello there, Dottie. Christopher, Amora. Hello. Hey, Michael. Sorry to trip you up there a while ago. Clara and Oliver. Hi, Oliver. Nice to see you. So, today I have invited a friend we haven't had here in quite some time to be with us again. Her name is Rosa. Rosa. Do you remember Rosa? Don't know. Some of you may not have been introduced to Rosa yet. Remember her? Yeah. Well, she is the first person in her family to be born in the United States. Her parents speak mostly Spanish, although they're doing their best to learn English. Rosa speaks both languages, and I just say wow to that because I can speak only one. Anyway, I've invited Rosa to come by to help us think about something very important, what it means to be home. So I'm going to go say hello. Oh, hello there, Rosa. It's good to see you again.
Buenos dias, Pastor John. That means good morning.
Buenos dias, Rosa. Good morning to see you too.
I'm always happy to be here, Pastor John. Coming here to be with you and the children always feels like coming home.
How would you say that in Spanish, Rosa? How would you say coming home?
You'd say regresando a casa.
Regresando a casa.
That's pretty good, Pastor John. Let's see if the children can say it.
Can you? Regresando a casa. Can you say that? A casa.
Muy bien. That means very good.
Oh, Rosa. Hey, it's so good to see you again. You said coming here feels like coming home. Regresando a casa. What do you mean?
Oh, I'm guessing all the children feel the same way, Pastor John. Children, when you think of home, what do you think of?
What do you think of when you think of coming home?
My mom.
You think of your mom. You think of your bedroom. Your mom and your pug, your dog. I had to think. I'm like, what's a pug? A dog. That's right. Anyone else? What do you think of that when you think of coming home? Your dad. Your dad, your church. That's wonderful. Yes, yes. Well, those are all just wonderful answers. Thanks for all of them.
What do you think of of home, Pastor John?
Well, I think of people that I love, and also people who love me. I think of family. Right now, I'm living with Sarah and Emily and Oliver. I think of children who are very young, and of parents and grandparents and great-grandparents. I think of a place where I belong and feel at peace. I think of some place where I can learn and also just have fun and be me.
I think of all that too, Pastor John.
And you feel all that when you're here with us?
I sure do. It's like coming home, regresando a casa.
Wow, I am glad you feel that way, Rosa. I really am. And I'm also glad that the children, I think they feel that way too.
Yes, Pastor John. It's muy bien.
Oh, That means very good.
Si, that means yes.
You know, Rosa, I wish more... Here, let me help you out. Your hair's getting a little... there you go.
Thank you so much, Pastor
oh,
John.
Oh, you're welcome.
I just get so excited being here.
I wish more people knew that they could feel at home in more places than just one. I think Jesus wants us to feel at home wherever we are.
Si. And if it doesn't feel at home, then maybe we can work together to help it feel more like home.
Yes, Rosa, yes. You know, once in the Bible, in a letter, a man named Paul wrote to people called Ephesians, it says this, it says, try to find out what is pleasing to the Lord. And then it talks about living as children of light, for the fruit of the light is found in all that is good and right and true. In the gospel according to John, Jesus says, I give you a new commandment, that you love one another. Just as I have loved you, you should also love one another. By this everyone will know you're my disciples, if you love one another. And how do we love one another?
Regresando a casa, by helping everyone to be coming home together.
Yes, Rosa. Coming home to church, coming home to ourselves, coming home to each other, and coming home to God.
Children, I hope you always feel like that. You are coming home when you come here to church.
Me too. I hope that too, children. Well, thank you, Rosa, for helping us all feel like we're coming home.
Gracias, Pastor John. That means thank you.
Oh, Rosa, children, everyone in our church, let's pray and please repeat after me. God, thank you for where we live.
God, thank you for where we live.
Thank you for everything outside, too.
Thank you for everything outside, too.
Thank you for birds and animals.
Thank you for birds and animals.
Plants and trees.
Plants and trees.
Thank you for our church.
Thank you for our church.
Thank you that everywhere we are.
Thank you that everywhere we are.
When we're with you.
When we're with you.
It can feel like coming home.
It can feel like coming home. Have a great morning in Sunday school, children. Hasta luego. See you later.
Have a good morning in Sunday school, children. Thank you, Rosa. All right. Because of some inclement weather we had this past... Yes, please. This last Tuesday night, our choir is not here again today. However, we are blessed to have our wonderful director of music, Kristen Noly, here with us again today. Give me just one moment. We'll move this puppet theater.
And test, test. Oh, you're so good. Thanks. Already on it.
All righty. Thank you for your assistance, Jason.
Thank you.
heaven's mercy seat. Holy, holy, holy is the Lord God Almighty, who was and is to come. With all creation I sing praise to the King of Kings. You are my everything, and I will adore you. I will adore you. Clothed in rainbows of living color, flashes of light, thunder, blessing and honor, strength and glory and power be to you, the only wise King. Holy, holy, holy is the Lord God Almighty, who was and is to come. With all creation I sing praise to the King of Kings. You are my everything, and I will adore you. Holy, holy, you are holy. Filled with wonder, awestruck wonder at the mention of your name. Jesus, your name is power, breath and living water, such a marvelous mystery. Holy, holy, holy is the Lord to come. With all creation I sing praise to the King of Kings. You are my everything, and I will adore you. Holy, holy, holy is the Lord God Almighty, who was and is to come. With all creation I sing praise to the King of Kings. You are my everything, and I will adore you. Holy, holy, you are holy.
Good morning. There was a day when we weren't yet known to one another. We were strangers along life's journey. Perhaps there were misunderstandings and darkness between us, but now we are children of light, and this light shines understanding on our different journeys, expanding our understanding of home and our desire to be strangers to one another no longer. Listen now from Paul's letter to the Ephesians, chapter 5, verses 8 to 14. I'll read from the New Revised Standard Version of the Bible. For once you were darkness, but now in the Lord you are light. Live as children of light, for the fruit of the light is found in all that is good and right and true. Try to find out what is pleasing to the Lord. Take no part in the unfruitful works of darkness, but instead expose them. For it is shameful even to mention what such people do secretly, but everything exposed by the light becomes visible, for everything that becomes visible is light. Therefore it says, "Sleeper, awake, rise from the dead, and Christ will shine on you." God, awaken us and move us towards everything which is good and right and true. Bring us home. Amen.
Thank you. I believe that you and I have some things in common. For example, I believe that each of us, in our own way, seeks home. We seek to understand it, we seek to be invited into it, and we seek to invite others to join us there also. As I was sharing on PJ's place, you know, depending on where you live, and you know, you are so fortunate, right, compared to so many in the world. If we are fortunate enough to live in a house, an apartment, a condo, right, you know, and you'll have, as I was sharing on PJ's place, like you'll have your way of decorating and the foods that you'll serve, but all of those things have this common intention, which is, you know, how to welcome, how to help others to feel comfort and good in that space. The podcast on Wednesday, I was so moved. If you don't know, the third Wednesday of every month, I'm out there at Life Care in Auburn. I lead worship there the fourth Wednesday of the month. I'm out there at Christopher Heights, sometimes other places. But I was just very inspired by the events of last Wednesday out at Life Care, and you know, and folks who live and work there. That's home. And quite frankly, as I was sitting here and listening to you sing, Kristen, just now, I felt very, very surrounded by all these, like, you know, I'm looking at the windows here, right? These stained glass windows. Our church has been in existence here since 1732. These gorgeous stained glass windows in some need of repair, this long-term goal. They've been shining light and beauty and color on those sitting in this space since before anyone here was born, and all those definitions of family. And I'm sitting here and I'm looking at these sunflowers we have over on our organ with a little piece of folk art, right? The flag of Ukraine with a heart in the center and the word peace, and all of this our prayer for as long as is necessary. And I'm thinking of people in Ukraine and what home means today. And that has me thinking beyond the surrounding countries and definitions of home. And I'm looking at these flowers up here that Elaine placed there as she's remembering her family, and these flowers here placed here by Joyce as she's remembering her son Drew. And I'm thinking of my son Oliver, my grandson Oliver sitting here and sharing about his definition of home. And I know Oliver quite well and love him. And all the children sharing their definitions of home. We live in such challenging times, and such times filled with opportunity at the same time, like never before, to offer one another home. In a book titled The Active Life, Wisdom for Work, Creativity, and Caring, from 1990, Parker Palmer, some of you may know of him, talks about an interaction with a spiritual director, and he says this in the book. He says, in the midst of depression, some of us understand that, some of us don't, in the midst of depression, I once asked my spiritual director how I could be feeling such despair when not long before the depression hit, I had been feeling so close to God. Simple, she said. The closer you get to light, the closer you get to darkness. The deepest things in life come not singly, but in paradoxical pairs, where the light and the dark intermingle. The Apostle Paul says, live as children of light. Try to find out what is pleasing to the Lord. Walk as a child of light. Work to discover the way of Jesus. Then walk that way to the best of your ability each day. Not everything is black and white. Yet the more light we shine, the easier it is to find our way along Jesus' way. Each of us stumbles and falls along life's journey. Lord knows I have. There's no easy or perfect way through. Life is messy, often painful. There are times of darkness in each of our journeys. If we don't come to know what darkness is, how can we distinguish it from light? Home is where there's always a light shining, like those houses with little candles in the windows. We do that at the parsonage because I don't deal well with too many hours of darkness. So we put these little candles in the window and they're just pretty. Tomorrow's the first day of spring, by the way. Happy spring. Home is where there's always a light showing us places within ourselves needing to be cleaned up a bit. We all have that. Home is where light shines on us, bringing healing to parts of ourselves which need some forgiveness and release from shame and fear. Home is where, I believe, we yearn to be. Darkness is important. Darkness of night is healing and restful, right? But the dark felt when you're feeling lost and wandering your own personal wilderness in a place of turmoil where relationships are broken and the bonds of home are fractured, that's another thing. In this place of darkness can live violence and despair and addiction and to experiences which rob us of life. And at some point, I believe each of us wanders in that sort of darkness for a time. We test it out. We try it on. We consider living there. Because maybe it feels good in the moment. But then one day, as children of light, we find ourselves yearning to be coming home again. Some folks spend their whole lives looking for home. Even some folks I've known who live in big, beautiful houses spend their whole lives looking for home. Others bring it with them. Others who live in much more modest circumstances bring home with them wherever they go. For them, home is less a place and more a relationship. And coming home in the ways that Paul is calling us to is coming home to a light which shines both on us and hopefully through us to others. sometimes too often, right, we get comfortable with the dark places in our lives. Might even deceive us for a time in thinking that that is home. Until some circumstance comes, shines light, and helps us see the truth of how we've come to be and has us doing everything we can do to be coming home once again. No one knew darkness more than Paul, by the way, the Apostle Paul, the writer of this text for today, great persecutor of Christians before becoming their champion. After his conversion on the road to Damascus, after the light of Christ turned Paul's personal darkness to light, right, Paul travels, spends the rest of his life traveling far and wide, becoming light, exposing darkness to light, transforming darkness with light. Throughout his letters, we experience Paul bringing the light of Christ with him, even into the prison cells, right? He's imprisoned several times, and even to the hearts of the jailers. Right, Paul is changing their lives, those who hold him physically captive. He creates relationship with them, with the light of Christ now burning within him. Paul sees the embers of that light in everyone. So he tries to help these tiny candlelights burn like mighty flames for Christ. Where is home for Paul? Home is within him. So if he finds himself in some dark, less than where he would want to be placed, home is still there. Paul brings it with him. When his physical surroundings are challenging, home lives within him. Relationship with the light of Christ lives within him. And he's not try something new. He talks to rich, he talks to the poor, he talks to the educated, to the uneducated. He tries stuff out. He's just trying to figure it out. What is pleasing to the Lord, to Jesus? He's willing to make an incorrect choice to get to where he needs to be. He does his best to live awake and aware. That's important. That's important for us. To live awake and aware. Having now woken from that self-destructive sleep that he was under, now seeing God's light shining through those whose lives he once sought to destroy, now home isn't a place. Coming home to himself, home is here now. From Genesis we learn we are created in God's image to be in relationship with God, reflecting his glory through our life and work. Paul says, yes, we are made to be children of light, coming home to God. I'll close with this thought. With every passing year, fewer of you I'm speaking to here remember this directly, but there was this ad campaign years and years ago. It would broadcast on TV, and it would say something like, and I forget the time, it's 9 o'clock, it's 8 o'clock, it's 10 o'clock, do you know where your children are? Right? Some of you remember that, some of you don't. It's such and such a time, do you know where your child is? Well, we need to ask that question of ourselves. Whatever the time, where are we? And are we at home? Come home to God dwelling with us here. Spirit and light dwelling within and all around us. It was so wonderful at the talent show last night. At Jacob's Hall downstairs where we'll gather after worship today to have some coffee and conversation, buy some meatballs. felt like home last night, right? Cameron's yo-yoing, and others are singing, and they're dancing, and we're just applauding every effort, right? That's welcoming the youngest among us home. And there's no place like it, right? Dorothy from The Wizard of Oz imagines herself clicking her heels together three times to get home. It'll likely take more effort than that for us, but we can get there. We're coming home, you and me, awake, aware, risen from the dead in some cases, here with Christ in the midst of darkness, yet not consumed by it. Home. There really is no other place like it. When you hear me say, where are we headed in this time of responsive prayer? Where are we headed? I'd ask you to respond, we're coming home. Let's pray. God, deep into this year's season of Lent, deep into this time of self-reflection, deep into the joy and the heartache of becoming aware, deep into letting go and holding on, where are we headed? We're coming home. Jesus, along your way, we feel both overwhelmed and inspired. Along your way, we seek both forgiveness and encouragement. Along your way, we strive to do the work. Along your way, as along that way, we yearn to simply know ourselves as children of light. Where are we headed? We're coming home. Holy Spirit, we hear your invitation so we may speak your invitation to a place of belonging. We hear your invitation so we may speak your invitation to a place of both comfort and challenge. Where are we headed? We're coming home. Amen. Well, now it is time for me to come and collect these plates, hand them to our ushers, who will hand them to you. For those who are inspired to do so, we'll also collect for one great hour of sharing at this time. Please, for our 100% self-supporting church, give just as generously as you can. Thank you. Dear Scott, I ask your blessing upon all these gifts laid on and around your altar this day. Gifts of time and talent, gifts of beauty, gifts of the best of us, the product of our labor, given in love through this representation of our love, this money placed in these plates, given to the ministries of this church family, given to the wider ministries of our beloved United Church of Christ. Bless the gifts, bless the giver. God, awaken us, we pray. Awaken us to the dawning possibilities of new life. Open our eyes, we pray. Open us to become fully aware of the wonder of this earth, twinkling stars on a cloudless night sky, sparkling dew on an intricate spider web, shimmering sun on an endless sea. Holy Spirit, stir wonder in us, we pray. Stir us to live with lightness of spirit, shining light upon whatever darkness within ourselves, within others. Forgive us the darkness we too often choose to live. Inspire us to live now in the light. Jesus, walk with us, we pray, so together we may be with those in pain, with those in need of comfort, a healing presence, with those who are ill, grieving, yearning for peace, needing a lighter load. And God, Jesus, Holy Spirit, when it is we who are in need of your healing presence, please give to us what we yearn to give to others, a place of home. We're coming home, God. We're coming home. Amen. Number 195, The Old Rugged Cross.
Yeah.
have to say, you were one of those who just did a wonderful job last night. Thank you for your participation. At one point, standing up and saying, you know, I'm not a comedian, but here's a joke. And I really laughed, so you don't know. This may be a latent, maybe not. I don't know. But you did offer one really great joke last night.
I actually forgot to say it.
Oh, just one second.
It wasn't my idea for the joke. My other grandmother, it was actually her joke, and she gave it to me. And I knew it would make her day if I said the joke. So I did it for her, and it made her laugh.
Have I shared recently you're a really good person, Clara? There's God. In this moment, it is so easy for us to see your face through Clara's face. We thank you for that, dearest God, and yet more and more and more and more. Help us to see your face, dearest God, through the faces of all, through the faces of those for whom, for us, it is a challenge to see your face this day. Inspire us to broaden the outreach of our love. Expand within us our understanding of home. Bless us and keep us. Your face shine upon us. Be gracious to us all, and give to all your world that which we most desperately need. Let it begin within our own homes and hearts. Your love, your peace. Amen.